Union Minister for Human Resource Development, Sri Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank ji, other dignitaries on the dais, youth leaders from around the world, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Namaskar, good morning, and a very warm welcome to all of you, especially to the youth leaders from 27 different countries. I am happy to be here to inaugurate the first World Youth Conference on Kindness. Few weeks from now, on October 2nd, we will celebrate the 150th birth anniversary of our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi. This event on kindness, a value synonymous with Gandhiji, is very relevant for us. I congratulate the UNESCO Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Education for Peace and Sustainable Development, Ministry of Human Resource Development, and other organizations that have come together to organize this event. Gandhiji was born in India, but he belongs to the entire humanity. His life and values inspires people across the continents. The most influential Indian of the 20th century, Gandhiji remains the benchmark against which we assess our public functionaries, political ideas, and government policies, as well as the hopes and aspirations of our country and our people and of our shared planet. He not only led us to freedom, but he also urged us to cherish freedom and preserve the concept of universal peace. Mahatma Gandhi was not just a great leader and visionary. He was one who personified certain timeless ideals and values. We could place Gandhiji in a time machine and transport him to any period of human existence, and we would find him to be always relevant. This is also true of the times we live in. Gandhiji remains extremely relevant to our present-day concerns, such as need for peace and tolerance, terrorism, and climate change. Ladies and gentlemen, Gandhiji believed in the ancient Indian concept of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, that is, the entire world is one family. This captures his advocacy of the theory of universal love and compassion. It means tolerance and openness to different cultures and ideas. It means non-application of any judgmental criteria except the criteria of truth. Mahatma Gandhi believed that our actions should ultimately aim to enhance the dignity and destiny of all human beings, more so those who are socially or economically disadvantaged. The world would indeed be a better place if all of us try to apply this principle to guide our actions and our thoughts. For Gandhiji, remaining firm on the path of Satya, or truth, and its pursuit was essential. This belief was the genesis of his movement, Satyagraha, which essentially means insistence on truth. His main tool in pursuit of Satyagraha was Ahimsa or non-violence. He considered truth the goal and Ahimsa the means. Mahatma Gandhi effected transformational changes by non-violent means. His powerful message of peaceful coexistence stands all the time relevant in the present times as well. His favorite bhajan or song, Vaishnav Jan To Tene Kahiye, calls for compassion, kindness, and goodness for others, for once and for always. His universal ideas have influenced some of the greatest leaders of our age, from Martin Luther King to Nelson Mandela. Ladies and gentlemen, the central theme of this conference is kindness. We can draw from Mahatma Gandhi to remind ourselves that the key to address many issues that humanity and our planet faces today lies in making our world more compassionate, human, and kind. These values have been emphasized in all religions too. For instance, in Buddhism, a perfect person needs to possess karuna, that is compassion and kindness. One of Buddha's great followers was Emperor Ashoka, the great Indian emperor from 3rd century BC. On one of his edicts inscribed on a pillar is as follows: Dhamma Shadu Kiyam Chu Dhammeti Apsinve Bahukayane Daya Dane Sache Sochiye. It can be translated as Dhamma, that is the universal law of nature, is good, but what constitutes Dhamma, that is absence of evil, goodness, kindness, generosity, truthfulness, and purity, unquote. We need to be kind towards Mother Nature if we are to stop and reverse the damage caused to our environment. We need to be kind to respect and understand differences, as failing to do so leads to conflict. We need to be kind to empathize and help others. We need to be kind to ensure that compassion becomes the inner voice that drives our children, societies, and civilizations to retain and nurture their humanness and their sensitivity. But how do we ensure that this indeed happens? We as individuals and societies need to cherish kindness as a value and a deed. Let us all consciously remember to do at least one kind act of per day. This alone will enable each and every one of us to practice and nourish our inherent kindness. If we do this, imagine that the sum total would be billions of kind deeds every day. Ladies and gentlemen, as individuals, as families, and as societies, we need to celebrate and share stories of kindness that we witness around us. By celebrating such act of kindness, howsoever big or small, we can promote goodness in our midst. Mahatma Gandhi also said, and I quote, "The simplest acts of kindness are by far more powerful than 1,000 heads bowing in prayer," unquote. Being grateful for what we have can also be a gateway to access our inherent kindness and its free expression. A simple exercise such as writing down every morning 3 things in your life for which you are grateful will enthuse you with positivity. Feelings of gratitude are known to reduce our anxieties and insecurities. Experiencing gratitude shifts our focus from our worries to the blessings that life has offered us, freeing us to share our innate goodness and compassion with others. The strife and violence that we see in the world today is often based on deep-rooted prejudices. These make us see the world through the binary of us versus them. Following Gandhiji's footsteps, we must let ourselves and our children interact and engage with those whom we tend to define as them. Greater interaction is the best way to develop a sensitive understanding which can help us overcome our prejudices. Ladies and gentlemen, here education too can play an important role. We need to evaluate and evolve the premise, goals, and structure of our education system. Education needs to go beyond mere literacy. Education must facilitate and challenge the youth to search deep within themselves and build their inner strength to sympathize or relate to our sufferings of others. We need to educate young people such that they can defy and transcend boundaries of class and race. We need them to be educated and creative to find solutions to entrenched structural injustices and inequities. We need an education that can touch our emotions and our spirits. In this regard, I am happy to know that over the last 3 days, you, all youth leaders and experts present here, have been working together in capacity building workshops focused on developing compassion, kindness, impulse control, and empathy. These are commendable efforts. It is important to be conscious of the need to be inspired and to live by these human values. Compassion kindles the light of compassion. An act of kindness is returned by an act of kindness and empathy. And empathy spurs empathy. I am sure that what you learn and experience in this conference will inspire each one of you to be the ambassadors of kindness for the rest of your lives. This conference has brought together youth leaders from around the world. You and millions of young men and women like you have the biggest stake in making our world kind, compassionate, and peaceful. All of you are celebrating kindness at a time when we are commemorating the 150th birth anniversary of the Mahatma Gandhi. I have no doubt that Gandhiji would have blessed this conference. Once again, I congratulate all the participants and the organizers of this World Youth Conference on Kindness. You have indeed started something that promises to bring Gandhian values into our everyday lives and make our world better. I wish you all the best. Thank you. Jai Hind.
National anthem, please.